Hi everyone, so today I'm going to show you how to use the new feature called Add Interactive Areas. So what is this? So this feature works exactly the same as Add Choice that we have. However, it is more powerful. So let's say whenever you're making a choice, you have a maximum of 4 choices, right? And you cannot really change any of the position of it on the slide. But with area, you can create customized size of area and you can position it anywhere you like. And you, moreover, you can make as many areas that you want. So since area works the same as choice, it will need variable for every areas. Now let's try to create our areas, shall we? So let's say I have a cat and you can touch it. If you touch it head or belly, it will be happy. If it, you touch it booty and tail, it will get angry. Okay, right here I can press Add Interactive Area. And I can select a new area. So this is the area that we have. You can use the finger to move it along. So the first area that I have will be the head. I need to increase the size of the box. So I just press increase right here. So this is the width and this is the height. So this looks good. And I select a variable. So I already create one, which is called as yes zone. Press it and add a value that you like. Usually I will put 1 in here. Okay, and add variable. Okay, so and add area. Okay, so for what about this part? Well, select a new area, position it, increase the size of it. Something like this. Okay, and select a variable. I also choose the yes zone and put it equal to 1. Okay, and add area. The booty part and the tail part will be a little bit different. So put new area, move it at the spot that you want. Okay, I need to decrease the size a little bit. Okay, increase the height. Okay, now I will still using the yes zone, but I will give it a different value. So put 0 in, add variable. The same thing will happen with the tail. Okay, wait. So we put the add area first. Okay. And add new area for the tail. Okay, let's see. Okay. And then the same will happen. I will use the same value at the booty to be 0. And then add variable and add area. Now you will see you have a total of 4 different area. When you press it, it will show the exact area that you given the variable. Okay, so let's return. So now, how can we lead it to go to places, to different reaction? So for the head and the belly, it will go to happy reaction. Remember the variable that we previously put for the head and the belly area? We put a condition for it right here. So we select the variable, yet zone. And since the both of it is 1, I put 1. Okay, for the booty and the tail, the exact same thing. But but with different value. So we condition it, we put a yes on, and we put 0. And now it should work. Let's try it out. Okay, so let's touch, shall we? Okay, so let's say we touch the head. It will give us a happy reaction, which is great. Okay. What about the booty? Okay, try it out. It shows us the bad reaction. So that's it. You just create your first area function.